Hello guys, welcome to this YouTube channel. This is Sonam and today I am going to show you how to create a task from SharePoint list from using Power Automate Flow. That means we are going to create a flow that will create a task automatically when a item is created in a SharePoint list, and also it will get the user profile from the task. So this is the preview of my flow that I have created to create a task from when an item is created in SharePoint list. So here the flow will trigger when an item is created in a specific SharePoint list, then it will get that user profile, that assignee person, and next it will create a task within the planner, Microsoft Planner, by assigning that username. And this is the preview of the result. So here I just created a SharePoint I have created an item by assigning that project name and project manager, assigning as the user 3, and in the planner it will create a task automatically by using the Power Automate flow. So let's see how to create this flow from the beginning. So in the browser, I'm searching for office.com to log in my user ID, Microsoft ID. So it will ask to sign in. So I'm here giving my user ID, then password, and click on sign in. Okay, yes. Now my user ID is logged in, and here I can find all the application that is integrated with the Microsoft 365 within this app launcher. And if you don't find any of application, then you click here all apps, and you will got all the application that is integrated with your Microsoft 365 based on your licensing. So as we are going to create a Power Automate flow, so here we will search Power Automate and click on the ellipses and open in new tab. And another one is SharePoint. So we will create a SharePoint list here. We will create item within the SharePoint list so that the task will be created. And next is planner. So where? Yeah, this one, planner. So first we will go to our SharePoint list. So here I have just created a SharePoint list, like name is projects, and here whenever we will create an item here, and in a project handler is a people column, and when we will assign a person here, then it will create a task within the task planner. So let's see how to create this flow. So here I'm just in Power Automate, click on the create, and here we will find all the types, varieties of the flow that we can create in the using the Power Automate. So click on automated cloud flow, and here we will give a flow name like create task from SharePoint list. Then here we will select a trigger, that is when an item is created, and click on create. Okay. So in the trigger, we will assign our site address. So site address is based on my name, and the list name. So list name is projects. So here we can see projects. So where it is that? Yeah, projects. So now we will add an action that will use that will get the user details or user profile. Get user details. We will find. Get user details. So yeah, in Office, under the Office 365 users connected, we can get that user, get user profile and version 2. So here we will give the principal name or ID. So for this only I'm going to give the email, project handler email. So here it is. Yeah, select this one. And so that means when an item is created, we will assign a username in that people column, that is project handler, and the flow, when the flow will trigger, it will, this action will get that user profile and create a task within the planner by using this to assigning this user. So for that only planner create planner. So to create this planner, under the planner connector, we will get that planner task, create a task. So select this one. And here we will give the group ID. So in the planner, there is different types of groups. So let's take that project plan, so that whenever I will create an item in the projects list, then it will create a task planner in the project plan. For that only, okay, let's go back. Here is project plan. I will select that project plan group, and the plan ID should be the project plan, and give the title. So I'm giving the title based on the SharePoint list title. Okay, so bucket ID is to do. So user can get that idea. Okay, start date. So start date is the date only. There is a date column in the SharePoint list, that is start date. So start date should be the start date, and the due date is the delivery date. So delivery date, and similarly here the assign user ID. So here we are going to assign user ID as the username that we will get from this user profile. For that only I will take that ID. So here this one is the ID, get you from the get user profile, I will take that ID. Okay, and that's it only. So let's save this flow. Before testing, make sure to save your flow. So this is showing that your flow is ready to go. We recommend you to test it. Okay, so let's test it. Click on test and test it manually and test. To see it work now, add a new list item to the SharePoint folder. Okay, that means first to see it works and how the flow is working, for that only we will create a item in the SharePoint list. So let's go to that SharePoint list, and so in the SharePoint list I will create a item. For that only, suppose I'm giving a created item like quality assurance. So my project name is quality assurance, then where the start date is, okay, 28, and the delivery date is I'm giving to 5 only, and who is the project handler. So I'm, for now I'm assigning to myself, it is okay, and that's it only. Click exit. Okay, so let's see whether the flow is run successfully or not. Let's check first. Yeah, it's coming with the green tick, that means flow is run successfully. Let's check whether the item is created, whether the planner is created or not. So in the project plan, let's see, let's refresh this one. Yeah, this is quality assurance, where the delivery date is 5/5, that means the due date it is showing, and assigning it to myself. So this is how we can create a flow that will create a task from the SharePoint list. So I hope guys you like this video tutorial, and so please give a like, and so do subscribe our YouTube channel for more free videos tutorial on SharePoint Online, Power Apps, Power Automate, Power BI, Python, Machine Learning, and many more. I hope you enjoy it. Thanks for watching. Bye.